Alright, let's finish with the main story. Negativitron incoming.
Machine elves were skipping through the dream flux, man. Branching and growing and splitting and singing. But I fixed them.
I see. So, huge spaceship is working again then. Chaps, all aboard!
I wonder what kind of hacks that is.
I think we should be leaving.
Wait! History will surely tell of this day. Maidens will weep at our humble sacrifice. Our names will be etched in the stars.
Ezorade, get out of here!
The time has come and gone for Oop!
He is still part of the life core, man. He's spinning, screaming, but he's got no mouth. He's a light bulb.
Is he still alive?
Avalon's wriggling off the mind plane, and time rewinds to a chrysalis. Not wasting a moment, let's blast off.
That's the most sense you've made all day. Woof, woof.
I see Higginbottom is like some sort of astral center and whatnot. Also, I love the background of Cosmos being like an arcade and whatnot. That's so cool. This is a journey ahead. Huge spaceship will ebb and flow around your dreams.
Summer, how are we going to feel no longer,
with the purest and a essence of beauty skipping along a light beam. Don't worry, she is. Have yourself around, Jack Thing. Amuse yourself.
Nope.
So yeah, it looks like he's inside a portal. Reality warp or whatnot. Here is where I might stop trying to go for. No, I thought. Like, maybe first try whatnot because. Yeah. okay games here. It sort of causes for it starts getting really difficult. Like every level going forward or not. Obviously, I feel like it's doable like, by replay. Like, I know I keep saying that over and over again. Like, I'm gonna stop here. If I can do it, I feel like a replay would just help out. If one replay is all I need and whatnot. Go first level now. Jumping.
Basic
No, we're going to crash. Their escape pods, they flit away like strawberry seeds in the wind. Hurry to their aid. Hurry to aid their exit. Hurry! The first thing we'll be seeing a couple of times in this playthrough. Zero gravity. We'll see this a handful of times during this playthrough, and not. Well, take care of it twice. This is one attempt at anything I know. I didn't actually try it, because I'm still never getting so good. Alright, 54 items, okay. I could have sworn those Moon Star costumes were DLC, I think, or something like that. I had it on. Believe they were doing the costumes. Yeah, that was a bad idea. Thank you. Yeah, I figured this first section is kind of a breeze. Second section is, yeah.
Thank you.
Intertwine. Intertwine. Extra one and as none. Get to that escape pod and get out of here. Alright, 49, yes. One diamond secret. One more from that. Alright. Draw harder. Oh, yeah, there's our set of outfit. Planetarium. Let's go Zack jumpsuit. Is that one portion I need to get past? I'll come back to that though. Yeah, so there's all the unlockable levels, all versus levels, so there's like no bonus levels, but that's not important rap. Anyway, let's get Full Metal Rap. Now we're sounds like the worst. Well, there's only like one section. It's gonna get pretty bad. That was pretty yeah, if I remember correctly, this is where things get much more difficult. Let's get onto Negative Sean's world. There's one little thing I can do, but yeah. Another problem is with these cutscenes or not. Help us! Huge spaceship has crashed on the other side of the planet. We're trapped inside a force field. There isn't much time. You see, we're going to dead meat and dead calendar. Oh, yeah, I know. Yeah, no, I remember what I said. I'm thinking it was fucking hot. Thank you. Yeah, as far as also like one, two, three segments. This level has that opening. Shouldn't be hard to see why that's a problem.
Gosh, I say, I mean, thank you. You need some help rescue your friend. I have something for you. This way.
Play blue. I guess is the answer to the question. Hey, where the fuck do all those costumes I was supposed to get? What not? It's a game in our world. Where in the world is Avalon's? Yeah. I will try to ace the final boss at least once or twice, but we'll see how that goes. I'll try to see about AC. There's one section I know is particularly hard when it comes to AC. Thing. We need to find Avalon. Hold on, and drop it. Shock button reinforcement.
Thank you. hot.
By choice, no cage can hold Avalon's centrifuge.
Yeah.
You're distracting the beast for you to make them blow. Avalon, are you suggesting that we just work as a team? Oh, why yes, Larry, of course I am. Damn, can we Avalon teamwork's introduced for nothing? Where's the exit on this thing? How do I get out of here? Flight of the Bumblebees. Alright, I can see maybe. Hey, so this one, this is never all score one. We must head deep into the heart of Negativitron. Let's try it. Noble Seed. Lead the way to the gates of glory. Dodging. Okay.
can already start that, because it's, yep. Yeah, no, I am not good at micro dodging. One thing for sure. Yeah, okay, it's not gonna be my touch too. I should be sure I get all goodies though, because that makes, because there's like no excuse to not get all goodies here. I can actually probably run through that. Got it, okay. Another plastic bottle. Okay, so there's a health refresh. Thank you. so about 3 more options, 3 more items. Difficulty, what not? They kind of strike the killing blow.
That is our
plan. Of course, it's depending on your sacrifice. Made you light speed, panda hat. Dragon bedside, big blue spaceship. Flight of the Bumblebees. Alright. Play on Sack Big Dude. Into the heart of the Negativitron. If we die and whatnot, so yeah. It is a pretty lengthy cutscene we have here. That goes nowhere, so, no we don't.
Oh,
That's pretty easy, why not? In phase 2, that's a top one. There's that spitier here. Okay, that's the biggest problem right there. But they move.
They shouldn't move.
So yeah, that basically throws a big wrench into not dying. I'll see if I can do this relatively easily or not. But yeah, that's section that usually gets me. God, my aiming is going terrible. Oh, you only get 2 tries. Oh, that's great.
Daniel here is doing it much faster than us. So you're unprepared for it. Sacrifice the cosmos. But I have been.
Did it? Or should I say, you did it, Sack Thing.
Slick, you rescued me, and you saved Craft World.
You did. And it all came together through teamwork. Come on, chaps. Let's go home.
I was eating a custard cream, man, and it bloomed into the perfect life of a baby. From one to another. Poof.
Okay.
Do not take lightly your hopes, your ideas, your fantasies. Let them grow. Nurture them. Then your wildest imaginings will soon trip the dream fantastic, soaring into the wonder plane and spreading into something altogether magnificent. And perhaps you'll see them again the next time you visit Little Big Planet.
Alright, that was Little Big Planet 2. I've had this Christmas for a long time. Yeah, so this is a very fun combat. It's fun to go back to Little Big Planet 1 as well, but this game feels much more joy coming back to this game than I did the first one. Much because just a refinement or not. I don't hate Little Planet 1, don't get me wrong. I don't hate it. I'm not saying that at all. I'm saying I enjoy this one a whole lot more. Also, this fucking song I hear basically the main trailer all the fucking time. And this replay through. Well, I definitely see where my skills improved a lot. I feel like I had the acing of levels was a lot easier here than with my 1 in some areas. Maybe this platform is a little easier, or maybe just because like it relied a lot less on the more technical stuff that Little Planet 1 could do but not do the best. A lot of Little Planet 1 platforming is a bit rough on the edges. Here, it seems to be very refined and cleaned up a lot. It looks a lot on the new gimmicks and whatnot, which definitely helped make platforming a lot more fun overall, and a bit more, like, and in control situation. The cosmos is really where I felt like I was struggling to get no lines lost in, simply because of, like, more so just the pure difficulty of it. Granted, you, of course, had the thank for Buck and taking over the Cosmos Full Metal Rabbit, which had the bomb issue. But even minus them, like, I feel like I could. You know, like, this. Which, granted, will always be a hindrance for any No Eyes Lost campaign, because. Oof, those things are a little short of sit. I can retry Hell. But I genuinely feel like the difficulty in the Cosmos overall is much more, like, actually, I see myself overcoming it with enough trial and error, whereas Little Pack 1, it feels like a lot more trial and error is needed, and it's more finicky stuff, but also a lot of frustration with some of the more finicky stuff they throw in there. But at first of all, I feel like I could easily retry a couple of times. It could take a couple retries. And I could eventually get the hang of that last bit. That last bit seems to be the only, like, real problem bit. As I get to the wheel section, it's fairly easy. But we are not done with Lily Planet 2. We still have at least 3 DLCs. I am gonna put those as bonuses, though. At least, mainly because of one in particular, requiring a bit more than I would like. So, for now, we're ending the project here. Or for now, we're ending the playthrough here. We will come back for the DLCs, though. There is technically one I can do right now, and another I could also technically do. Because one of them in particular requires spoiler, the places to move stuff. I'm gonna need some time to get that stuff. I'm gonna need some time to set that up and whatnot. Because I don't have any of that. We had that a long time ago and we never used it pretty much. But oh, that's just kind of a neat idea. It's kinda like, because we play PlayStation a lot as a kid. And like, oh, this is kind of like Nintendo Wii for the PlayStation. It's like, we kind of forgot why that was a bad idea. It took me until adulthood to realize why it was. It took me to, like, after PS4 came out to realize, this is why it's a bad idea. Because, I think intrinsically, I knew it was a bad idea as a kid as well, because, like, I never used it. Period. Yeah, there are at least 2 DLC packs, one that came bundled with this special edition, and one I can purchase that I can, we could do, but I want to save, but we'll get back to those when not. Let's say one of the DLCs though, the DLC because you had though, oh my god, I know, it is a difficult one to say the least. Like, you see how difficult the Cosmos? Basically, that's the difficulty for all the DLCs going forward, pretty much. We're looking at Metal Gear Solid Pack, where it's like, oh, it gets a little difficult near the end. No, it's difficult throughout. The Cosmos is basically the difficulty we go on forward. And of course, we'll come back for more bonus stuff. For, like, community levels and replayability and replaying levels for all the goodies with that. So we aren't done with Plan 2, not by a long shot. But I'm thinking, just because I need to get stuff for later, and I don't want to, like, halt variety hour just so I can get that stuff, even though by the time this comes out, it's gonna be much later on down the line. Like, seriously, this is gonna go on at least a month in advance. Well, more than a month in advance of when it's being streamed. But either which way, I still want to... Yeah. Yeah. It won't be that long of a week, though. I don't think it'll be that long of a week. Yeah, we're on this little bit playing craze for a little bit, because I do want to... But while we're on this little bit playing craze, we're going to get a little pit stop. As much as I want to get the free, I want to test see if what I did would allow me to get my goodies when I into the plan free. I'm hoping I can do that. I'm not sure if it's possible, though. That's the reason I'm rushing the Live Planet series, so I can try and see if, hey, can I do this Live Planet 3? That will determine whether or not I start trying to gain more DLC and whatnot. If you're watching the stream, that will start next week. It's gonna be a game. Oh boy, it's a bit more contentious, if you remember correctly. And plus, I will not have any DLC problems because that game did not have any DLC. Yeah. And spoiler, I mean the portable games because I love it. I can't transfer any of those. And I don't have PSP either, so. We'll get to those eventually, but those are going to be much later down the road. I'm running out of the plant mood of like games I can transfer stuff to or not. I don't want to see if I can transfer stuff to the plant free. If I can't, it's fine, it's whatever. It's just, it affects some things, but not a lot of things. But yeah. But yeah, there will be more Little Big Planet coming soon. Sorry for those who don't think what's it. Oh my god, they're creating stuff that DLC I can't buy anymore. That's fucking great. You can't buy Elite Incredibles, you can't buy Marvel, you can't buy Toy Story. You can't buy Muppets. It's too much digital. Oh my god, there's no music. Come on. They made the credits extra longer for this fucking version of the game. God damn it. I can't say that for certainty, but it feels like it. For fuck's sake. Oh my god. Yeah, those are some little packs I wish I could have played in a Little Planet 1. But, oh well. Can't get them anymore. If I can find a way to get them, I will show them off, because they are so fun. And I have had fun with those, but yeah. Unfortunately. Who's who? Thank you all for coming. Have a great rest of your day.